Crops in the Deccan are generally rain-fed. In the Zahirabad region, the home of the Deccan Development Society, not a single acre of land has the benefit of canal irrigation. The only small river which flows through the region is dammed to build a reservoir. This supplies drinking water to the city of Hyderabad, which is 100 kilometers away and is groaning with a population burden of over 6 million people. Consequently, no water is left for irrigation in the Zahirabad region. This situation makes it critically important to retain the rain-fed nature of cropping in this region. Korra is a traditional millet grown on the semi-arid lands of the Deccan. In spite of its capacity to grow on marginal soils under low rainfall conditions, in spite of its nutritional superiority, the cultivation of this crop has gradually declined. Today, Korra is on the verge of extinction in this region. Biodiversity festivals of the Deccan Development Society, a five-year-old tradition to celebrate the amazing diversity offered by rain-fed crops. This festival is also a forum for farmers to come together and articulate their concerns. A forum where gaps and impediments for their agriculture are debated and solutions found. The festival forums have identified an important reason behind the decline of korra and the drop in its use by the farming households.
అదే మన కొర్ర బియ్యం మనద వన్య బియ్యంను అదే రేషన్ కార్డులకు ఆ బియ్యం ఇచ్చే వదలు మన కొర్ర బియ్యంని ఇస్తే మనకు అప్పుడు మార్కెట్ అనేది పెరుగుతది మనకు ధర వస్తది.
Traditionally, it was de-husked using a combination of the grinding stone with a layer of leather inside and a pounding stone. But this is a difficult drudgery and makes the life of women so much harder. It is also a very time-consuming process, and time is tough to find. The debates in the DDS biodiversity festivals brought this aspect out into the open. The issues raised were genuine and needed a solution rather urgently.
ఈ పాత పంటలు కూడా పెడితే కూడా ఈ మిషన్లు కూడా ఈ దంచజాలకు కూడా పెట్టకచ్చరు మరి మిషన్లు కూడా కావాలి.
These suggestions led the Sanghams of the Deccan Development Society to search for a technological solution for the problem of processing korra. Farmer Jayappa, representing the community concerns, explained the specific characteristics of korra to the engineers of a mechanical firm and asked them to develop a hulling machine.
పండి చెట్ల మంచిగా ఉన్నది తిన్నట్లో కూడా మంచిగా ఉన్నది, అన్నిట్లో మంచిగా దంచుట్లో తిప్పలు ఉన్నది అనమాట. బియ్యము సన్నగా అయితే దీన్ని తీసుకుంటే ఎన్నో రోగాలకు తుచ్చి అయితే అనమాట. ఇవన్నీ దీనికి జల్దీ అయితే బియ్యం తీస్తే.
Extensive discussions took place between the engineers and the farmer on the prototype to be produced. Several changes were made on the drawing board. When the final machine was developed, it was truly a participatory technology development. Issues identified by farmers and the appropriateness of the technology guided by them. The final machine was installed in Pastapur village, where the Deccan Development Society is headquartered. On October 16, 2001, to celebrate the World Food Day, the millet machine was inaugurated by the Medak district collector, Mr. Premchandra Reddy. This was a historic occasion for the communities of Medak. They had designed a machine to solve a problem of their agriculture, their nutrition. And their food sovereignty. It was a technology that they had appropriated for themselves. A technology that would create more opportunities to strengthen their rain-fed farming. 4 years later, on January 1st, 2005, the millet machine found a permanent home at the millet complex built by the DDS Sangams. In 2005, the small machine was processing nearly 200 kilograms of korra every day, a quantity which would have occupied about 20 person days otherwise. But the machine has not taken away jobs from people. Instead, the tasks surrounding the machine have created livelihoods for dozens of women on a sustainable basis. It has removed drudgery from them and helped them to appropriate a technology instead of letting a technology appropriating them. Farmers from distant villages have started bringing their produce to the millet complex to get them processed. In its turn, the millet machine today travels to different villages and has become a permanent part of the DDS biodiversity exhibitions. It is taking the message that millets can be retrieved and used without hassle. By rallying round the millet machine, the communities of the Deccan have given a new lease of life for a millet that was almost on the edge of extinction. And they have designed and used a technology to their needs. A perfect example of how people can lead in technology development.